chairman of this academic program, Mr. Saraogi, Professor Trilochan Shastri, Director Dr. Premi, Mr. Anil Agrawalji, all the faculty members, guests, parents, and students. Let me first congratulate all the students who have successfully completed their PGDM course and have been awarded the Diploma in Business Management. Let me also congratulate the medal winners, their parents who must be feeling proud of their own daughters, because there are no sons today, or the daughters. At the outset, I would like to say that this is a moment of inflection. All the medal winners, they should be proud of their performance, but at the same time, they must be proud of their parents, their family members, their brothers, their friends, they're all their colleagues. Because we know that a person is a combination of all these factors. Nobody should think that it is I who have achieved. No doubt, as a person you have achieved, but all these people have contributed in your success. All these people have a role in making what you are today. And therefore, while you should be proud of your performance, of getting medals and having passed the examination, but at the same time, you must have humility to thank all others, including your class fellows. Now, I would like to, at the beginning, I would like to reveal a fact that I am reminded of 1995, when this institute was started. I came here as a visiting professor for a few days, so I am really nostalgic about it, that all the 22 years have gone. At that time, I had come in a different capacity, delivered a few lectures, I think, twice I came, as far as I can recall. And today I am here to deliver the convocation address. I myself feel proud of coming back to the place where the first, the first or the second batch, I had an opportunity to give lectures to them. Now, very important aspect of this, that from here, when you go to your workplaces. Now, the final exams, all those having done all these, when you go to your workplaces, the first shock that you will receive is that everybody will ask, well, do you know management? Everybody asks, do you know management? You have knowledge of some theories, but do you really know management? And then you really feel a shock that after having all those 2 years of grueling education, why this question is being asked? Now the question is being asked because people, those who are in a workplace, they are not very much bothered about how much knowledge you have. They would like to judge you from the viewpoint how useful, how productive you are for the organization. And often we think that what knowledge we have and how we perform, they are very perfectly correlated. Actually, many times it is not. And then you get a shock that whether all that management education I had, I have been a topper of my batch, whether it was really worthwhile or not. Because many of the things that you learn, you are not able to implement. And then the questions come. Then you try to meet the two things, performance at the workplace and the learning that you have done. And often the organizational people, whatever organization you join, they really want sometimes that you unlearn whatever you have learned and try to learn new things, new techniques, new methods, new tools, even new values. And then you face a dilemma. And often you people, or often many of the educated people, tend to think, and others say, that theory is different and practice is different. I, for one, do not subscribe to it. Whatever you have learned, that will be useful, that may not be useful directly. Say next day you are given a problem in a finance and you will straight away try to apply whatever you have learned. That may not be so. Even that is not the objective of management education. Management education does not directly prepare for tasks. Management education is about developing understanding. The objective of management education, and for that matter every education, is to develop understanding. The second objective, I think, is to stimulate thought. That is why an educated person is often a thinking person, because he thinks, starts thinking about new things, new acts, new processes, new products, which those who are not very well educated may not be actually doing. The third objective of management education, I think, is that it provides you the tools. And with those tools, having learned them properly, you will be able to apply them to most of the situations, may not be all the situations, because often situations will come where whatever tools you have learned are not directly applicable. Their understanding will help. The understanding will tell you where to use what tool and to what extent. And lastly, to give values. Bereft of values, no long-term success can be achieved. Short-term achievements can be made, but bereft of values, long-term success cannot be achieved. It will lead to disaster. I think having understood this, when you go to work, you should only think that my foundation has been built, and based on that foundation, I have to perform. Because ultimately, everywhere, an organization, everywhere you will be judged based on your performance and not necessarily what you have learned or what you know, what are your presentation skills, what are your communication skills. They will all be treated secondary. The first thing that you will be tested on the yardstick of performance. Now, how to get performance? It is hard work, no doubt. It is very essential, and it is a very biggest secret. It is no secret at all that hard work is very important. But performance should be productive. It should lead to some outcome and outputs. There was a time, at the time of Marx, when there was a general thinking that more output can be achieved only by working harder or working longer. And if somebody was producing more, that person always thought that it is my work. But F.W. Taylor changed all that. He said that working harder or working longer is not the only way of higher productivity. Redesigning your job, doing the work in a proper sequence, will yield much greater productivity than merely working hard. That point, that is what I want. I don't want to belittle hard work at all. But only working harder, that I have been working very hard, that is not going to suffice. Because when you are going in the business organizations mostly, there you will be tested on how much productive you are. And if you have been continuously productive, you will go up the ladder very fast. And if you are not, then probably some people might have to face some frustration at some point of time. Now, how to improve performance? That is one point. We are in the 21st century, and this century is said to be a century for knowledge societies. The methods that were adopted by Taylor, they were for manufacturing work, physical works. Now these days, physical works, manufacturing works are lesser, and greater is what is we call, what Drucker says, knowledge workers. The greatest focus these days is and would be on the knowledge workers. Now, how to improve productivity of knowledge workers? This is a very essential thing. It is not merely that you try to improve some steps in the whole production line. Instead, a knowledge worker is required to look at the whole process to see whether that process is essential at all or not. Because there are various ways of doing it, and one has to be innovative. Peter Drucker often says that be innovative, and innovation does not mean only that bringing out some products. How a particular work can be done in a different manner, in a more productive way, with a lesser use of resources. And knowledge workers will be tested by that. Higher level managers will always be tested by what changes in the organizational working that you brought about, with which, with the same effort, you produced more. And this is a very essential thing. That is why I said, management education is not merely about doing, it is about thinking, understanding, and stimulate thinking about new products, new processes, in a way, innovation in general. Now, how you will proceed? When you go to work, you often feel that whatever we have learned is management is about managing men. The essence of management is managing men. But you will often find that managing subordinates is not so difficult. Managing man, that means is your boss, is much more difficult, but much more important. Managing your colleagues is also equally more difficult and more important. So, how you cope up with those situations? That is where what we often see, the soft skills come in. Your ability to work with people in a group. That is the most important thing. And most organizations, at most of the places, whenever there are three or four people, everybody wants to go in different direction. And when they try to go different direction, because everybody has a different agenda. And there where the performance, because the performance in these modern times is not merely your own. It is the performance of your group or your team that will really matter. There are often people very good, very intelligent, very productive, but they are loners. They can't work with a group of people. But those who have an ability and those who gradually develop that ability to work with a group of people, they really have a chance to go much higher. But how do you develop that? And for that, the most essential thing is about developing your leadership qualities. Now, leadership qualities, often there are many theories of leadership, but it is not merely the charismatic personality. That is not the only essence of leadership. Often it is only a beginning, but it often fades away. The leadership is about trust. The subordinates must have a trust in the leader or the manager, and the manager must have a trust about their subordinates. Now, the trust does not mean that there should be a continuous agreement. If the leader and the subordinate continue to agree on all issues at the first sight, probably they are not discussing things. Probably they are not thinking people. So subordinates should also have a chance to give vent to their feelings, emotions, different thoughts. But the ability of the leader to churn all of that and bring out the best solution, that will be the test of leadership of everybody. So it is a trust. It means that the subordinates think that whatever the leader is saying, he is meaning it. If they tend to think that what he says and what he means are two different things, then immediately the trust is gone. So your ability to work in a group is very essential. And for that, you will have to continue to develop a feeling of trust with your subordinates, with your colleagues, peer group, and also your seniors. And if anybody who is able to manage all the three dimensions, subordinates, peers, and seniors, and of course supported by the hard work, well, hard work also develops trust, then I think that the sky is limit for everybody. You will have a very high career, and from one organization to another, you will always continue to walk higher, and then one day you will recall this day, nostalgic. You will become nostalgic about the day that I studied for 2 years, then there was a convocation, I was conferred this degree or diploma. That started my career, that started my life in reality. And on that day, this institute, sometimes in future, recall your names. They will see, we are very proud of this and this person who studied with us. And then you will also feel that I studied at that institute. You will recall your teachers. And that is the way an organization, an institution, and individuals grow. I feel that this institution, right from beginning, has made a hallmark in this city about the quality education that they want to provide. And all the facilities that your director has just narrated, including an international visit, is contributing in that whole process. And I will really congratulate the director and the institute on this 20th convocation. And I wish all of you a great success in your life. Thank you very much.